Hello friends, now we are going to talk about what is actually Octet rule and what is the significance of it. But before understanding what is Octet rule, this is the thing that we have discussed in our earlier lecture only, and that is electronic theory of the valency. And this is similar to that we are going to talk about. That is, whenever a bond is formed between the two atoms, then we know that is it is formed because of the valence electrons. But meanwhile, we should know that the valence electrons of a particular atom during a bond formation, it should be an electronic configuration to the nearest noble gas. So that is what we are going to talk about. So what is octet rule and what are the significance? Let us talk about it. So now let us understand what is octet rule. So according to octet rule, that is during the formation of a molecule, an atom of a particular element gains, loses, or either share electrons with the other atom until it acquires a stable electronic configuration of 8 electrons in its valence shell, as in the nearest noble gas. So this is what the octet rule is. So we know that only the noble gases are the ones which have basically a complete octet, or we could say like that of the neon, argon, krypton. They have complete octet in its outermost shell, and that's the reason that we say for helium. Helium is the one which consists of 2 electrons in its outermost shell, and that's the reason it is not the one which follows the octet rule. But and that's the reason all the noble gases actually they don't combine with that of the other atoms or other we could say elements, because they have well satisfied their outermost shell with their, we could say, like 8 electrons. At least they have the 8 electrons in their outermost shell, and they don't have any excess of electrons, or not they are electron deficient in terms of the 8 electrons that we know. So that's the reason they don't combine with that of the other elements. But meanwhile, the atoms that we know that they have their outermost shell, they have either 1 electron or less than 8 electrons. So their valency is they have a particular valency, but that valency is not in satisfying the complete electronic configuration, because they don't have 8 electrons in their outermost shell. So obviously what they have to do is they have to lose their electrons, or they have to gain some few electrons so as to acquire a stable electronic configuration which consists of 8 electrons in its outermost shell. And that is what this results in the bond formation also. So this is what we have discussed in our earlier lecture also, but let me give a small example in this case so that we could understand it in a better way. So if I talk about that is, again, this is the same thing that I'm going to talk about. And suppose if I'm given an example, that is NaCl. So this is a short example that I'm giving here, that is talking about the sodium. Sodium has an electronic configuration of that we know, or we could write it as that is 2, 8, 1. While talking about the Cl, that is chlorine atom, that has an electronic configuration that we could write it as that is 2, 8, that is 7. Because the atomic number of sodium is 11 and that of the atomic number of the chlorine is 17. So in this thing, we could say that sodium is the one which is not having a complete or we could say it is not having a stable electronic configuration because of its valence is 1. But what if it loses 1 electron? So once it loses 1 electron, so therefore the electronic configuration of the sodium, it will turn into 2, 8. So that is very much similar to that of the neon. So that is how always during a bond formation, an atom tries to acquire the stable electronic configuration compared to that of its nearest noble gas. And talking about the chlorine, so chlorine has an outermost shell of 7, means its valency is 1, but the valence electrons are 7. So it has to, that is, gain electron from somewhere, and then only it will become, that is, 2, 8. So electronic configuration of chlorine will become 2, 8, 8, and that is somewhere that of, we could say, like argon. So now argon is the one which has complete which we say that it has 8 electrons in its outermost shell and it has a stable electronic configuration. So meanwhile, while taking 1 electron, even chlorine will be the one which will be like that of their argon, and that is how the stability would be maintained in terms of electronic configuration. So that's the reason. So two atoms, they either give electrons or they take electrons, or either they share electrons, but they have to behave like a noble gas, or they have to consists of the electronic configuration that should be stable compared like that of the noble gas. So that is how the bond is formed between these two atoms, and or we could say in a molecule we could see a bond has been formed. So that is what I was talking about the octet rule, but let me talk about the limitations also about the octet rule. So talking about so this is what we have discussed over here, that is NaCl is the one that forms a bond between, that is bond formed between Na and Cl. But when we talk about hydrogen or hydrogen molecule, so hydrogen molecule is H2 and we can write it as H bond H. But talking about the electronic configuration of hydrogen is, we could write it as 1, and that of the other one also you could write it as 1. So obviously we have talked about that either electron should be gained or it should be shared or it should be lost. So somewhere it should happen in that way. But suppose if hydrogen is the one which has one electron, and if it accepts one electron from the other hydrogen, so it will have an electronic configuration of 2. But 2 is not the thing that we know as octet, because octet is the one that we know it has 8 electrons. So that's the reason it is a stable molecule that we know, but it is not obeying octet rule. So similarly like that of the lithium also. So lithium which has an electronic configuration of we could write it as 2, 1, but even lithium, that is, it forms a bond between another lithium also. So again it is not forming an octet in its outermost shell. So that is the limitation, but still it is found to be a stable molecule. So that is what I was talking about an octet rule. And but now let us talk about the significance. So what is the significance of octet rule? The main significance is it gives the detail about the valency. Yes, so now since in the previous one that we have got to know, that is so the both were following the octet rule, and that's the reason that sodium is the one that forms one bond, or it forms a bond by giving its electrons. So that's the reason that the valency of sodium is 1. But meanwhile, when talking about the chlorine, chlorine also forms one bond with that of the sodium, but it forms bond by, that is, taking the electron or gaining the electron. So that is the reason that the valency of the sodium and chlorine is the both is 1. So this is how we can discuss about the various that is bond that are been formed, and by then we can also get to know that what is the valency of that particular atom. So talking about like the carbon dioxide, so carbon is the one that is forming two bonds, double bond, that is between one oxygen and another double bond between a carbon and oxygen. So in this case the valency of the carbon is basically found to be 4, while that of the oxygen it is found to be 2. So this is all the concept that we are discussing related to octet rule. So that is the main significance that we have talked about. And the next significance that I am talking about the octet rule, it gives an idea that a particular atom can form bond with which kind of other atom depending on the valence electron. And that is the thing that we have discussed about the octet rule. And this gives, not only gives a detail about that whenever a bond forms between the two atoms, the bond forms because of the valence electrons, or we could say that the atoms try to acquire, that is, electronic, stable electronic configuration. But yes, there are more details that we have got to know, that is in terms of valency or in terms of the bond formation to which kind of atom. So that is what their octet rule has a significance. So that is, friends, that is I want to talk about. And thank you, friends, for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly, and you will share this video with the friends. And don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.